Mark Scheifele.
Yes.
Blake Wheeler, show us
again.
The good stuff, EJ.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, it's these guys have such a connection and such a chemistry. Here's a shorthanded play with a simple two-on-two. Now, they get Rantanen, who is a forward. They have four forwards and one defenseman, and Rantanen's just going to kind of get lost in this coverage. He's obviously not paid to play defense. But just look at this nice chemistry.
Yeah, this is a poorly defended, but the fact that Wheeler's able to just one time, it makes all the difference in the world. So Scheifele goes back to him, and there's no holding on. There's no dusting it off. And the little give and go, these two have mastered this. And when you get to go on one forward there, you know you're going to get a good chance. But these two together are just perfect.
All right, now I want to look at this one. This was an interesting play because I wanted to know how Scheifele got so open on this play. He drops his stick. So you got to remember, he's dropped his stick. He's going to pick it up. The play unfolds. And then there's not a great pass by Landeskog there. Wheeler gets it, but by the time he has picked up the stick, he takes off, and he's wide open, and then a great finish. And we'll see it here again. And let's give Mr. Wheeler a lot of credit here, because if he rushes this, Eric Johnson is right there to block it. He holds it a beat. Eric Johnson kind of slides past him right there. I don't think Eric Johnson knows at that moment that Scheifele is that far behind him. You wouldn't be expecting that. And then the great play by Wheeler just lays it right out in front of Scheifele, and he comes in. And how about the finish? Save. Oh, it's up in the air. Oh, yeah, I got no problem. I'll just tap that in.
Yeah, the hand eye on him is no joke. And I think, you know, sometimes Eric Johnson may look like the bad one there, but that's a tough pass by Landeskog, and all of a sudden there's nothing.
That's right. Yeah, there isn't. I mean, it did put him in a tough spot. But I don't know. I don't think EJ really knew, like, that he was there, because you wouldn't suspect the player to be that far behind. But it happened only because he dropped the stick.
Yep.
And then Landeskog, when you watch that tape, he does try to force that play through. That's when you're chasing the game, right? Mm-hmm. You're down a couple of goals. You're chasing the game. You're trying to make something happen.
Yeah.
He makes an ill-advised pass, and the Jets make him pay.